We are definitely very excited to be here today because this is our first time lecturing here. And first of all, we want to thank the British Dance Council for inviting us. It's an honor to be here. And it's also a very special day for us because exactly on this day, our adventure started in some way because we won the Under 21 10 years ago, exactly the day today. So that's our past that kind of started back then. And today, we're lecturing at this prestigious Congress. So that's the past, and this is now the present. And now we want to present to you some of the things that we believe is elements very important in order to create a unique style and hopefully influence the present and leave something behind in the future. Now, this is a great world that we dance in and live in. There's so many personalities, there's so many great dancers from the past that has influenced this industry that we dance and love so much. So we believe, or we feel that sometimes can be a bit of a challenge actually, to leave your mark and create something truly unique and leave something that people hasn't seen before yet recognize as a Latin dance or a Latin style. Yeah, so there's the constant challenge between being very true to the authentic Latin and the authentic principles, yet create your own style. Now, we have created this system to make it a bit more tangible to how to create this unique style. Yeah, so our title of our lecture is Unique, but with the emphasis of you. It's your time, it's your chance, it's your possibility to actually create your style and leave something behind. Now, in order to make it a bit more tangible, we make these three layers. The first layer, which is the technical layer, yeah? The second layer, which is the intention, the layer of intention. And then the third layer, which is the layer of sensing, the human element, yeah? Technical, intention, and the sensing. Now, why we chose those three elements is because, first of all, we think that those three elements is part of any kind of dance, or actually any kind of art. Now, I love food, actually. I don't get to enjoy it that much in these days, but normally when I travel around, I love food. And the best way to kind of give a life example is this. If you go into a restaurant, and a chef has to prepare a certain meal, he needs a skill, he needs a technique in order to be able to get the flavors out of this product. If he doesn't know how to grill the steak, you won't have a nice steak. Now, he also knows what he wants, what is his vision with this dish. He has to put it on the plate, combine it with different kind of vegetables or whatever. The combination of the products and how he presents it to you is his intention. Now, once you put that food in your mouth, it's your senses that get activated, and you get touched. Yeah? So in other words, the technique, you can appreciate. The intention will draw you into the dance or the art, and the sensing will touch you. Yeah? So, let's kick it off, because we don't have a lot of time, and really want to give some nice elements to it, yeah? Technical element. Now, what is technique? The technique is exactly a skill. It's a craft. It's a way for me to create something, go somewhere in a most efficient way. Yeah? So it's for me to be, it's a tool for me to create something. Yeah? Now, we see that there's two aspects of the technique, if we talk about the dancing here. There's the fundamental technique, which in some way is what protects our unique style of dancing. We have to study this fundamental technique in order to be able to appreciate and to know what is it a rumba makes look like a rumba. What is it that Latin American, what is the difference between Latin American international and the American rhythm? Even though we still dance the rumba, both of us. Yeah? We have to know those things also in order to be able to create your own style, yet make it look like a rumba. Yeah? Now, one of those, we're going to try and go straight into the dancing and show you one of our favorite steps. Can I borrow my lovely partner, Ina? Now, We're going to take just start around in the Cuban rocks. Yeah? So, I'm going to dance the Cuban rock. Now, there's three elements in this that we think creates the Cuban rock and that we enjoy. It's the Cuban motion. It's the weight transfer of my own, but also in between the couple. How do I change that weight? And then it's the proximity between the man and the woman. So even if I want to change one of those elements, for instance, I want to change the proximity, it's easy for me. I just change. And suddenly, the step looks different, yet it's still Cuban action, still proximity, still weight transferring between us. Yeah? So it's to see those three elements and to know them, because that's the basic step. How do we now take those three elements and develop them? Now, this is a part of our routine that we've chosen, and we played around with bases based on the Cuban rock. It's not a Cuban rock anymore, but it's based on the same principles. Yeah? So. There you go. Thank you. Now, if you maybe saw this on the comp, you might not recognize it, but you still see that it's based on a rumba. Our goal is not to make it look like a Cuban rock. We dance a Cuban rock straight after, so you can appreciate it there. But it's to know that when we dance this, boom, proximity, Cuban motion. Weight transfer, playful of weight, Cuban motion, and weight. Now if we continue, Ina does her favorite step, the rumba walk. And now we dance the Cuban rock. Yeah? So can you see? Thank you. In order for us to develop it, we take those elements and change them. But we know them and we relate them to the music. Yeah? Great. Now, let's move on to the next element because we have a lot in store, so we want to show you more. Now, the next element is the intention. Okay? Now, what is intention? Intention is what I feel the movement with. It's my purpose for the movement. It's the message I want to send. Yeah? So, why do I do it? What it's the importance to me and how I use that movement to tell, for instance, a story. Now, again, you grow in your career, you develop and so on, and what's important is intention, it's a plan. I want you to see something. I want you to get an effect, for instance, or I want you to get touched or whatever. Now, we have a piece in the cha-cha, which we dance as amateurs. And it was a side-by-side piece, so it went something like this. So it was a one. Yeah? So that's quite fun and entertaining, right? And it served its purpose as amateurs, and in context to what it was. We danced some closed hold before. Oop. Is that me? No? Okay. It's the fire alarm. Just stay calm. Okay? It is the fire alarm. Okay. Should we just ignore it? Yeah? Okay. Great. We try to ignore it and stay calm, yeah? There's another alarm starting once there comes smoke, so don't don't panic. Now, it served its purpose. Ina and I, on the other hand, we have developed and we have gone into that we want much more dialogue. This was kind of side by side, very on your own. Now, we would like to have much more dialogue and we must have much more body intention. Yeah? So we played around with it and we developed it. And we just want to show you. We're going to show you to music this time, okay? So, track number 2, please. Now, you could see it developed, and if you haven't seen what come here, you wouldn't maybe necessarily find the link between it. But we based it on communication and rhythmicality. And yeah, it didn't have the same effect, but now something else has its another effect. Yeah? Great. Now, Ina. Shh, there she is. Ina's just going to talk about intention again. And just link it a bit more to the story. First, have about the body part, and then link it a bit more to the story in a simple way.
Hello from me as well. So this is a very dear topic to me, because I really feel that this is what makes what I do really meaningful to me. So basically, the intention, how I feel the movement with purpose. And the good news is, I think you can reach that in many ways. For example, if I run a story in my head, I have become a character, I connect to that character. That is an imagination I use. So for example, if I may just leave that here for a second.
Beginning of our room or routine, right?
Yes.
It's okay. I think you can hear me, right?
Yeah.
Good, thanks. So for instance, I can play that story in my head and I tell it to myself, basically. I walk slowly in that room and I feel the light dripping on my face as it goes slowly down, down to my hip towards him. He moves away, I can sense that, but he's approaching slowly towards me. And I choose to ignore him completely. So this is a way that I can run,
This is a way that I can run my intention in my head. Therefore, my body supports whatever I'm speaking to myself. But I'm not thinking, get it. They should desperately understand what I'm doing. I'm speaking this to myself. So this is one way. But the good news is that I don't necessarily have to play a Hamlet in my mind in order for that to happen. It could be a pure body-sensed intention. So for example, same step.
I will completely devote myself to how that foot moves on the floor, how slow I stretch it forward, how it goes up through the thigh into my spine, slowly release my weight, stretch towards my knees there, my spine moves to me. This time around.
It's coming. Thank you. So in a way, besides the same step, I hope you saw at least, my intention was to show you that the driven thought was different, either a story or a pure body sensation, which then leads us into the third layer, which is the sensing part.
Right? Yes. So I think it's quite clear. We're not desperate for you to get that story. You might see something completely different, but we tell ourselves a story a intention that's going to fill that movement with purpose. Yeah? Can you take this one? Yes. Now, what was quite clear for Ina is that we're just trying to organize a system with elements that you literally can't separate. What I mean by that is when Ina did the intention of the leg, she's sensing that touch on the floor. She's sensing the touching of her own skin. She's sensing all those things, because the thing is with the senses, it's already part of us. We have to activate them. We have to try not to block them. We have to be aware of them and be very present in this moment in order to make it real. In other words, we can't preset the human element, because then it's a part of the intention. Oh, I want to touch her, and I suddenly touch her, but no, I'm not touching her. I make it look, I want you to see that I'm touching. But how does it actually look when I'm really touching or really looking and making this real? Really going away. I'm not trying for you to see it. I am doing it. It's real acting. I'm not trying to fake it. I'm doing it. And that's what gives me pleasure, and that's where you connect to it, hopefully, as well. Now, in order for you to just get another idea of how we use those three elements, the technical, the intentional, and the sensing, we're just going to show you one part, which is based on one of our other favorite steps in the rumba, which is the three ala mana and the rope spin. Because we feel that this is one of the most skillful steps. It's quite difficult and skillful, but we're taking the challenge, and we have also been brought up with learning those basic principles and learning those basic combination of figures in order to train it. Yeah? Now, let's just do the basic version straight away to music. Track number three. Thank you. Now, this is all based on basic steps, a very basic combination, which can be appreciated if you put that on a competition floor, especially compared to a lot of the other things that's going on. Now, what we did instead of saying, okay, we do this directly, how can we challenge it and use some of the elements that we enjoy the most in this part and emphasize them, exaggerate them, and make them into a competitive routine 2017. Now, let's just do it straight away. We're going to show you what we dance in the routine and see if you can find the links between the two. One more time, track three. Yes, thank you. Thank you so much. So you see, we've taken those, for instance, if we do it from a fan, I'll just quickly walk through it. I know we don't have a lot of time, but We're going to squeeze it in. Ina Rumba, in from a fan too. Ina would have two walks. Walk, walk. Now, in the beginning, I think Ina has great walks. So she should do some more, right? So, in the beginning, instead of doing the two walks, she would have the three walks. Four, and one, and two, three, four. We overturn the three elamana. Give this an extra bead to time that weight together. Now we go into the rope spin, but we overturn it and center behind the back. We go into the back basic, but we make a turn, center behind the back, and go into the telemark. There we go. So it's based on basic principles. No, it's not the pure fundamental. But we have to learn that in order to know how to build it around these steps. Yeah, so it's not just fancy tricks. It's built on the same principles as there is in the Cuban rock. Yeah? Now, yeah, we have a little bit of time left, not a lot. But I hope you had a chance to see how we layer our dancing, because it is layers. And all these layers that we built and put on ourselves throughout the present, throughout the past, and throughout the present, some of them we have to scrub off, and some of them we really have to build on. And that's what we did in our dancing here. We took some of those layers, the fundamentals, and we tried what do we feel that we can develop them, yet still make it look and respect this unique style and these unique principles, which is made to make this dance musical and make it look like a rumba. Yeah? Now, we'd just like to finish this lecture off by dancing our rumba. And hopefully you can see some of these elements, the technical, the intention, and the sensing. And again, it's just part of us. It's just how we like to express those music. And hopefully you get it. But by the end of the day, it's our enjoyment, our commitment to those steps and those choices. That's why we do it. We go onto the floor and we present that to you. And hopefully you feel a bit of what we're feeling. And hopefully you get touched as well. And hopefully we leave something behind that people will remember and will appreciate. Yeah? So, it went really quick for us. At least we could talk much more about this. But we want to show you just the rumba, and then we want to thank you all for being so attentive and listening and kind. And we want to wish you all very best and much, the best of luck in this week. And definitely see you all around, or hopefully next year again. So, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.